trip's been planned for about 9 months now, in its basics, from the first idea. Since then we've had regular meetings, we've had two training weekends up in Holland, testing out the bikes, some of the extra equipment we've put on them. But essentially it's been 9 months of regular planning, getting the trailers put together, getting all the equipment in the right place at the right time, so that we were ready to go. So it takes about 9 months for this sort of trip. The plan is, we have a circuit lined up, we have a route. In fact, it's a circuit made up of 5 routes, which takes in a little bit of everything. It's out to the north east of Mauritania. It takes a little bit of everything, so we've got some dunes, we've got some mountain plateaus, we've got flat scrubland, we've got rocky terrain. To find another location, there are a few options, many possibilities, but actually shy of going back to Algeria, which is worth avoiding at the moment, and Morocco is a little bit done, it's a little bit touristy, and Mauritania is a very interesting and very little known part of the world, and it's got some beautiful sections, parts of desert. So I thought I'd come down here and check this little known part of the world out. The support team vehicles are 2 Land Rovers, a 110 and a 130. Both have modified suspension, they both have modified transmission. They're very, very capable machines. On top of that, they then have extra and other equipment with them, such as air compressors for tyres. They both have a full suite of communications, so on both vehicles we have satellite telephone, HF radio, VHF, UHF and airband. Communications in the desert are critical. You may see the big antennas. We have water filtration units, we have cooking, GPS navigation systems, 240 volts, 12 volts, a lot of equipment. And generally all of it gets used at one stage or another, or all the time. Spend it on how the trip goes.
What do you have there, Jerry?
It's an iPod. I have more than 6 days music on that. So I can stay in the desert for 6 days. After that, I have problems.
What kind of problems?
No music anymore. So I have to charge that every day. Specific desert stuff.
Two or three things. Reset your odometers to 0, please. We'll start measuring the fuel. You should have a full tank of gas. I'll give you your insurance certificates in a moment. Please get them with you. I think that's better. What we'll do is we'll go off as one big gaggle to start with, so until we get to the tarmac and the big turn off. And then from there we'll see how things are going, everyone's happy, and then we'll go for it. Okay, but the main thing certainly to start with this morning is drive or ride safely and keep drinking a lot of water. See the guys wearing jackets, I think you'll get very hot very quickly. What's going on, boss? Well, the situation is stabilized. Thierry's now in as little pain as he can be in. So what we're going to do is we've got an hour and a half from here to back to the road. So we're going to have a quick lunch, make sure everyone's got all food and happy, and then we'll go back very calmly and carefully back to the road, back to Nouakchott, and get into hospital, see what the situation is, relaxing night, and then tomorrow we'll start off again and we'll see what happens. But we need the first priority now is to get everyone back into a position of safety and get Thierry to a hospital. No, I'm very sorry for Thierry. It's extremely bad luck. In some ways it's very, very bad luck it's on the first day. It is fair to say that it is much better now than any day from now on. That is the only good thing about it, that we're only an hour and a half, 2 hours from tarmac. Later on in the trip we're going to be much further than that, and from the capital city. So that's the only bit of good news, but it's just very, very bad luck. It's one of those things on a motorbike you can fall 100 times with no problem at all, and you fall once and it can be the bad way.
Je moet hem niet laten lachen, want dat doet pijn, hè? Gaat gaan. Moet je er een sandwich van hebben tussen uw boterham?
Short tip. Sam, what's the plan this morning then? What's after yesterday's events?
Right.
What are we going to be doing today?
Back on track, cracking on again. So what's going to happen is the white Land Rover, with myself and Nick, we're going to go earlier. In fact, we're going to go quite soon. Get ourselves out and on the track. Then the guys will follow, go via Thierry. Say goodbye, make sure he's all right. And then they're just going to go by themselves. And the thick one bring out the tail. And the guys then just going to have a clear 200k solid up to where we decided to stop. And then there we'll probably take a long siesta and have some lunch. Avoid the heat of the day and then crack on again at the end of the afternoon. But today's going to be the first day where we run things as they're supposed to be, which is the guys with long and a lot of independence. Hopefully having seen what can happen if it goes wrong. So riding with a bit of prudence. So fingers crossed, should be alright. And they have everything in place anyway to keep it as safe as possible. Should be a good day.
Morning, Kurt. You ready for another big day on the bikes?
A big day, yeah. Yes, it was a very, very big day. Listen, just hold the camera upside, okay? I change the one moment. Okay. And here we are.
What was going on there?
Ik verander gewoon van broek, jongen. Okay?
What about this trip?
Oh, this whole trip or just today? Probably the whole trip, yeah. You know, it's the combination between the riding of the motorcycle in unknown land for us, the camaraderie with all the friends, and also the campfires at the end of the day where we find each other and just be with some friends together. It's the combination of the three which makes it the event for where we always look forward to for the past 2 years.
Hello.
Yesterday you had a lot of heat, a lot of sun.
Yes,
what happened?
I just dried out. I was a little thirsty, to put it that way. No, I didn't drink enough in the morning, so suddenly the sun really hit too much, and then I felt dried out and quite weak. But then tonight things went much better. Drinking 8 liters.
Are you feeling better today?
Yes, ready to hit a new day, to restart, and I hope we don't come back.
Locust juice from yesterday, but Sam was very specific about one shirt, so it's important that I not lose my only shirt. It was inside the house there, but it's especially meaningful to me because of the locust juice. If I get caught in the desert, I could always get energy from the locust juice. But I'm sure, there's one.
Ready to go.
Hello, Thierry.
Hello.
What happened yesterday?
Well, you saw it. I felt and I broken my, I don't know, my bone here. I don't know how you call that. and it's over after half a day. It's a pity, but it always can be worse. So let's be happy. I had a good weekend.
The accident will not stop you.
No, no, no. Otherwise, if I can't drive a bike anymore, I have a Toyota, I can come with a Toyota. So I will come back, that's for sure.
Philip's bike.
Yes, one little piece of metal, I can't drive anymore. One link broke.
We've got a broken chain on Philip's motorbike. Our lock stat is 44 decimal minor kilometers to the west of your current location. We're trying to fix in house, but I'm not convinced I have the tools.
Sam, it's Jamie. We've got a problem with Philip's chain, which has snapped. The link has broken as an inner link. I'm looking for the tools now, whether we can cure it, but I'm fairly certain that the tool that we require is in the back of your wagon. So we're going to try and effect a running repair as we speak, and we'll see if we can cure it later on.
Roger, I'll give you another 5 minutes, and then I think send Michelle back with the tool. Over.
Roger, again, I'll keep you updated, but I think, yeah, plan for him leaving in figures five, over.
Roger,
we don't have the tool here to fix this, so I think we're going to have to wait for Michelle to come back down, unfortunately. Obviously, that's too hard for the hacksaw.
Yeah.
It's just cutting into the wrong piece, because the pin is harder than the chain itself, which is why that's broken there. I think if we try any more, we could end up knacking the chain.
Yeah.
So we'll just have to wait for them to come back. It's going to take them about 25 minutes, I guess.
Yeah, it's 40 kilometers. Yeah.
It's 40 kilometers, yeah.
It's quite hot, yeah. Very hot. I thought yesterday was hotter, but maybe we're getting used to it.
Laag in de toeren in het zand?
En ik zat een beetje te laag in de... Ah, ja. Nee, ik zat iets te hoog in toeren. Ik zat eigenlijk een beetje te hoog in toeren. Zo pop, 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 en dat plots...
Ja, te laag in toeren.
Te laag in toeren. Ah. Ja, ja, en te hoge versnelling.
Moet je altijd...
The bad news is that all the spares for the bikes are in Brussels.
Say again?
You forgot them? What?
Forgotten.
Sam forgot the box with all the tools in it.
We'll go. Should I feed this lot?
some spare parts.
Jamie, you have fresh water?
Yeah. Maybe see if we can, if it'll fit. You think that's just too short?
Yeah, but we...
There's not enough room.
The problem is if the chain is breaking, we don't have any choice.
No.
The thing is, at what other places is the chain again broken?
Is there any place in town that, is there any motorcycle?
No, we still have one chain left.
Oh, we do?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, it's in...
Where?
It's in the workshop.
Good bike.
Mm-hmm. What's your reading? What's going on there?
Seems like the chain that broke originally isn't only broken at the point that was obvious. As we dismantle the chain again, it transpires that the chain is either rotten or it's got more than one stress on it or whatever. Plus the fact it's proving very difficult to undo. So therefore it looks like we're still running with it, may not be fixable. So it looks like we may have to go back and take or bastardize the chain that is on the one on Kurt's bike back at the campsite. So we just kind of have to run with it just now, but it's not looking great.
How far is the campsite?
Campsite from here is another, it is about 15k back to the road through the sand, and then it's another 70k back to the campsite through Nootshot.
What exactly did you leave behind in Belgium?
The box of spares. Quite a few spares did make it, but quite a few didn't. Unfortunately, they're all in one box, and I've put them somewhere nice and safe, and they're still nice and safe somewhere. It's very frustrating. I still don't know where they are, but they are somewhere in Belgium. That's it. I can say sorry a couple of times, and then we just crack on. Luckily, there's always a good side to every cloud. Because we have Thierry's bike spare, it means we've been able to turn Kurtz into what we used to call a Christmas tree. A Christmas tree is something you go to and you take presents off. So they've gone back to Nootshot and they've stripped Kurtz's bike of all the bits that we might need out in the desert. So in fact, we've lost half a day, but it's not quite the disaster it could have been. So I've been lucky there.
So has anyone been giving you a hard time yet about leaving that vital box of supplies back?
Not yet. Michel a little bit. I suspect when Michel gets back from his marathon day of 30,000 million kilometres, he'll probably have something to say, and it's a fair one. It's very possible.
Couldn't see and those goggles, those clear goggles, are all scratched, so I couldn't wear them.
Oh yeah, yeah.
I didn't have any fucking goggles.
What? Was it hard?
We have a small box with his bike.
We only took the bits to work, though.
Well, we took the best piece. That's a fact.
It's over now. It's my bike.
Well, you will see what I stripped of it.
That was great.
That was great. In the dark.
I couldn't see. I didn't have my goggles. Because they're dark.
Lost the tooth. Oh. Oh.
And will they work the ketting?
Yeah, but... Oh. All us.
You can't see the wheel, you have back. Alles.
Is niet waar.
Meen
je
dat?
What are your feelings about your bike now?
Just lost half an hour.
Jesus.
So you're back?
Yes, we're back. We went for the fifth time. We did that little piece of road between Nuakchuk and A3. And we went back to Nuakchuk to find some spare parts, but didn't find anything. However, we found a good motor shop. They can ship anything, DHL anything, to Nuakchuk, capital of Mauritania, in 24 hours. But we decided to take apart bike number 8 since somebody left, so now we have spare parts from the bike that we have with us. So back in Belgium, two people are standing by with spare parts, with DHL, and wherever we want it, we can maybe do that as a route B or another solution if we have any problems for the next days.
Cool. And what was the issue with the donkey? You nearly killed the donkey?
Oh, no, no, no. There's just camels and donkeys on the roads and people driving very fast. And there was that donkey who was in the middle of the road. The guard almost missed a donkey, almost missed a stand, and just went off the road. But that was a minor issue. But there are lots of animals on the road. Camels, donkeys, and goats, yes.
Are you hoping to buy a goat this time?
Well, goat is still on. Now we're off in the desert, so we'll definitely go for at least one night. We'll have a little goat. We have to find it, but I think I'm confident we'll find it. Yes.
Will you kidnap one if you have to?
That was a good
one. No, no, no. We'll find the goat, have a little discussion with the owner, and then we'll take the goat and have a good dinner. Sure.
Mijn filter zitten, ze hebben die er al uitgepakt. Verstrengd. En wat is dat hier?
Dat is een bougie, dat is niets.
Ja, maar ik kan dit niet uitleggen wat dat allemaal is.
En wat gaat er dan nu mee doen?
Wel, mee nemen. En
daarna weer in.
En er gaan allemaal terug op steen.
What's this? This is what's left of.
That's Koos' bike. Have a look at his bike. Nice, hè? Eh? Nice piece of equipment.
Okay, what do you think? Thank you.
backtracking towards A4. There's no way through the dunes up there. This is the spot where, just prior to where we had lunch, and Sam went through it in the white Land Rover. Ollie and I followed him, this pink one clearly, and I guess I cocked it up. Started third in low ratio, went into second, didn't have the pace, went into first, lost momentum. There was a bit of a clank and some strange noise. It sounded like it kind of had diff lock. So we stopped. Well, no choice. It stopped anyway. Re-engaged the diff lock, checked it was still engaged, and it don't bloody work. So we've dug it out, we've faffed about. Sam's tried to drive it out. Transpires, it looks like it's only driving from the two rear wheels, which means we might have a fairly significant problem. If it's only driving to the rear wheels, it means that there's a link failed somewhere. I don't know enough about it mechanically. Sam's the guy to speak about that. He's gone to pick the other Rover. We're going to winch it out, get it onto the hard stuff, and then have a look. But potentially, this is a significant problem.
What does that mean to layman if two wheels and driver?
These Land Rovers are permanent four-wheel drive. Therefore, when you put in a differential lock, it means that it will always drive three of the four wheels. So that means there's always power through the wheels. Because only two wheels are driving, it means that there is a link broken somewhere, because it's always one front and at least one rear. So for the layman, it means the vehicle, as it stands, don't bloody work.
Only one hop. Only one. Great.
Okay, we do that?
We cut it.
Cut our throats.
I leave sand with this problem here. Okay?
It's not our problem.
We have our goat, we have cake, we have sun, we have sand.
We have we've got, what do we have, Jack Dan? No, we got Scotch Black Label.
Yes, and we have Red
and
Sox.
And J&B.
And we have Red Sox.
That's right.
Yeah.
Fresh.
Look, tourists.
Oh,
tourists.
He's pulling it out quite a bit. Oh, boy.
Come on with sunglasses.
And, well, it's been interesting. We wanted some adventure with lots of humor and some drama. We had a lot of drama since the last couple of days, but that's what we came for. And I think we can do two things: start to complain about it, or keep on smiling and not joking about it, but keep on smiling. And I think the morale is good, and everybody is behaving the way he should. So it's great.
You put a world of air in all classes. They're way low.
Okay, let's talk about this world of air. How much is that?
More than there is at the moment.
Okay.
Yeah, just pump them up a bit. It's a technical.
See, whenever you do that.
It's a technical term. Don't know yet, is the answer. Certainly there is some drive going through to the front diff, which is what I was concerned about. I don't understand why it didn't drive out of there, unless it just wasn't properly in, but it felt properly in. So I don't know yet. I think what we do is we work on the basis that it may well be okay. It may well be okay, in which case we carry on. Well, we need to carry on in some way, shape, or form anyway. But we'll get the tyres back up to a usable pressure, and then we'll see how she goes for the next 200 metres, and that will tell us whether we have a real problem or actually it was something strange, that the gear lever just wasn't correctly placed. So 100 metres and we'll know.
We've just pulled the Land Rover out, hoping we have four-wheel drive again. Sam's about to try right now. He says within 100 meters he'll know. He'll probably know within 5 meters. What we really want to see is the front wheels turning as soon as he takes his foot off the clutch.
Centre diff's gone.
Sam, what's happening?
Yeah, the centre diff has failed. Centre differential, which means we can't lock the middle of the transmission. Which means we've only got drive in the two back wheels. Which means, we have a big problem.
Take this moment.
We'll
certainly try and fix it, but otherwise what we're looking at is back to Nouakchott and try and get some sort of four-wheel drive lorry. Come all the way out here, get her on the lorry, get her back to Nouakchott, or even a helicopter. Talk to the army, see if they get friendly. But I don't know if Mauritanian army have a helicopter. We'll see.
We'll have a party for a couple of time now. The reaction to the news?
Out of speech.
Speechless.
I think we will have to think about how to further get on with this. So, if I understand well, Sam, he'll have to go back to Nouakchott, guess with that white one, unload everything. And I don't know. I think we'll have to get together and see how we take this further on. So, well, morale is still good, but just a couple of degrees lower, I guess. Now, we'll get there.
So, whatever we do, we set camp
right here. The 100-meter test didn't work.
Okay, let's
2-wheel drive differential knackered.
We don't need to go back to Nouakchott.
So, they're going to have a quick look, try and take it off here, try and repair it.
Yeah, it's 4 o'clock.
So if that doesn't work, Sam's mentioning,
it's too late today.
We have to somehow get back, all of us together. Get either a truck out here or a helicopter, which is, I think he was probably joking on that one. But, you know, these things happen. It's a real expedition. The boys will club together and we'll get it sorted. It's not so far back to, we've got, what, 20Ks back to A4. And maybe some of the guys go tonight, but again, we'll just have to wait and see what happens. We'll take this out, but this is not going very far tonight. Boys are taking it well, it's good.
Where's that rug?
So was this bad karma for the goat?
No comment.
You reckon it's bad karma for the goat?
It can't be good.
You've got the goat's tail on the back of your helmet.
That was given to me though, I didn't actually remove that tail.
By the goat?
The goat gave it to me as a parting gift. GDA had its testicles and scrotum. That will probably be edited out, right?
So we unload the thing.
What do you think? Can we fix it? Or are you going to film us disintegrating? So yesterday we obviously had a problem with the front diff on the Land Rover. That's eventually what we worked out exactly what it was. We worked out the best solution or the best plan was to take the whole assembly off. As you can see over my shoulder, we've taken off everything from the front UJ, so where it goes into the front diff, off, all the way down across the wheels. We're taking the whole unit with us, and we're fairly certain it's the front diff, but just in case it's actually further down the line of the transmission. And the whole lot's now in the back of the 130, and now myself and Jamie driving with Michel on a bike as a sort of outrider. We're going to make our way back out of the desert, which will be its own trip. Go back to Nouakchott and replace the centre diff and then come back out here to collect the guys again. So the guys have an interesting day out here in the middle of absolutely nowhere, not being able to do very much, and probably a little bit of worry that whether we're going to come back or not. But assuming things go, if things go very, very smoothly, we can actually be back here tonight. But more realistically, we'll be back here tomorrow morning with a new assembly, which we will then fit and then we carry on. Or more importantly, we actually get back to the correct position, and then we carry on the trip. But for the moment, it's a bit certainly for the bikes. It's all stop, and now we have our work to do to get the support wagon back up and running again, so we can carry on.
Morning.
Morning, Ollie.
Day 4.
Oh, already.
Monday, they tell me.
Yeah.
So, what more could go wrong?
Oh, a hell of a lot, I think. We had Thierry's injury, but we could have a much worse injury. But let's not talk about it, or not think about it. What else can go wrong is that they can't fix it, that they can't get back here in time, which is maybe tonight, and we all know that it will probably be tomorrow. And that would be difficult, because at that time then we will start to run out a little bit of water. We'll have to cook a lot of water, and especially it will be very, very boring spending a whole day here. Although the first day we'll play cards and whatever probably, but it's going to be very hot between, as you know, between 10 and 24. So just hope that they will get back by tomorrow morning, or well, let's hope by tonight, but that will be very tough.
How are you going to spend your day today?
Well, I think we'll have to organize some water purification squad. We'll have to, that will be a very important thing, because we probably consume, Guido just calculated it, he said 50 liters of water a day at least. If we have to do that with that pot and with a fire, it's going to take a lot of time. Basically, it's purifying water all the time. And part of that, just playing around, not too much with the motorcycles, because then we take probably risk again. And just talk, sleep, play cards. You promised me to play poker, so we'll do that.
Have you got your checkbook?
Well, I know you have a lot of money with you.
How's morale? Yeah.
I think morale is good. Everybody has, well, we had the discussion yesterday night together with Sam and you, and then we had a discussion among us. And the agreement, the common agreement, was that it might have been good to have Michelle along with the Land Rover. So that happens, and I think we do now all we can to fix it. So everybody feels, not comfortable is a big word, but everybody feels okay that things will move on, and that's what we came for. Everybody against about things that. This is part of the adventure we wanted. So as long as we can get back on the route at one point in time and not too long, I think it will be a great trip.
And you said Tuesday afternoon, we have to be on the road.
We have to, well, we have to is a big word, but that would be ideal, I think. And then there's another four days left to That would be great. Good combination of a lot of drama and some driving, some riding. That would be, yeah, fine. That's it.
Seemed very easy. Seeing as the Land Rover is a lot lighter now, as we've taken all the fuel and supplies out, it seemed to handle that a lot easier than yesterday. So that's very encouraging, and hopefully we should have an easier trip back to A4. Once we get to A4, that's the main crux for Sam. We've got to find A4 because it's a big hill between us and A4. And once they're there, they're cruising back to the capital, and hopefully to a new Land Rover part. And yeah, they should be back tomorrow. And the Land Rover over there, that's looking slightly distressed, should be back on the road, as should the trip. But yeah, interesting day ahead. Guys seem very cool about it all, enjoying the experience. And yeah, things will work out, as they always do. Let's go get some breakfast. We'll be right back.
happen. They arrived. Never believe that it's done so quickly.
Allez, ça c'est bien. Allez, pour commencer maintenant.
Bon, Michel, and
fast. Yeah, fabulous. Good job, Michael.
Ja, ja, maar zij ook, hè. Ze hebben ook serieus gereden.
Michel, how was it?
The first 6 hours were fun. The last two were hard, but okay, it's feasible.
I think it's done.
Now, the only thing which we have to cross is that it was the only broken part in it. The part we get back is okay, that's for sure. The rest of the land, we presume it's okay, so tomorrow we will be able to head on.
Sam, so this morning, what talks of the day?
Okay, so as planned, we got up early. As planned, we left early. We turfed out almost everything from the 130, put in minimum requirements for us in terms of petrol for Michelle's bike, diesel for us, and water for all three of us. And we went, took our personal kit with us. We got about 5Ks down the valley. The original plan was always to try and stick with the valley and find an easier way over the dune ridge to get back to A4. So we carried on down there, and we actually picked up another track, and eventually we actually stayed in that valley all the way to the road. So we never went anywhere near our original tracks. There are some quite interesting bits on it, so depending on how we go tomorrow, we may or may not see some of the other parts. But we didn't have the big climb, which would have been tough. So we got back to the road, actually in quite good time. Carried on back to Nookshot. Got to Nookshot for about half past 12 or so. No, to about 12 o'clock. Found the Land Rover garage, half past 12. Guy started taking the axle apart. Found that the whole differential was completely smashed up. Quite a few of the teeth split, and one of the joining axles broken. So certainly nothing we could have done here in out in the middle of nowhere. And then we cracked on. He got that repaired, got water, fuel, had a beer, went for a swim. Well, no, that would have been nice. And then jumped back in the wagons, bought a bit of food on the way out of town, and have burnt it back and managed to get back here at about 20 minutes, half an hour after sundown. So the last 20 minutes, half hour were quite interesting. I'm driving at full belt in the desert, in the dunes, in the night, but we're here. So normally, we will start putting this back on now tonight. Time is of the essence. Get it fixed up so that first thing tomorrow morning we're back on some sort of plan. What that plan is, we'll talk about around the fire, around supper this evening, where we're going to go and how we're going to do it next. Because we've solved one problem. Our new problem is we need to find the correct way. What is interesting though is having spent most of the day going back and forth, as far as I can work out, we are actually in the right place. So we need to find another right place, which is going to be easier. But that's all for discussion this evening.
forward to today's ride?
Yes. At least I remember we're here for biking.
Has it been frustrating?
Not frustrating. It's like that, and you can't do anything about it. So that's not the point. But happy to be on the bike again. Look forward to the day.
Yeah,
you
have shot with
you see? See? Yeah.
You
have
shot?
Yeah.
The mark.
Yamaba Kaluza Natoma Mamma.